Hey everybody, today we're going to be cleaning this rug that I'm standing on right now. Now this rug is over 100 years old and has a couple of stains throughout, especially this one right at my feet here. Now our customer thinks that this might be coffee. We did a little bit of testing. It looks like it's removing pretty easily. So we're going to take you through the entire rug cleaning process for this one here. We'll work on the stain and let's see how it comes out. So the first step here, we're going to give this rug, we call it a pre-scrub and rinse. And we'll see how much dirt we get out and see if any of that darker stained area starts to release. There's a couple of reasons we do the pre-scrub and rinse. The first being we want to remove any loose dirt and soil that we can without having our cleaning solution have to fight through that layer to get to the more stubborn dirt. And then the other reason we do it, which is that what you're actually seeing on the rug right now, is we don't know if there's any soap put on this rug from our customer, or this rug's 120 years old, it could be even way before that. We don't want other cleaning solutions to interfere with our cleaning solution. We want to make sure we get that out before we introduce any of our own cleaning chemistry. Now that we've rinsed and scrubbed it, we're going to do our heavier roller squeegee. Let's see how much we get out before we even start cleaning the rug. So we see a lot coming out there. We're going to do this process a couple more times, and then we'll get to the next step. So the next step in our cleaning process is the first step where we actually start to clean the rug. We're going to put down our cleaning solution. You've seen a lot of our videos. You know how we do this. Basically, we have a bucket with holes in it, and we pour our cleaning solution into that bucket, and we walk around the rug. And then we will scrub it in. And on this particular rug, we're going to let it sit for a while and see if we start to break up that stain. We're gonna let it sit for a little bit, and then with some movie magic, it'll be about 2 seconds. All right, so this spot here isn't really coming out from the regular washing process. We're gonna try one other thing on the wash floor here. And if that doesn't work, we'll try some things once we've actually cleaned the rug and dried the rug. this is our rug centrifuge. Now you can see the rug inside. What this allows us to do is rinse the rug very thoroughly, so we get any more dirt we left behind, all the soap that we used, and then allows us to get the rug very dry. In about 3 minutes, this rug, once we're in the drying phase, it'll get about 95% dry. See on that first rinse how much more dirt came out of the rug. This machine is replicating our fire hose and squeegee process. It's doing about 15 times a minute. So we're gonna keep rinsing this until the water comes clear. Now you're gonna notice on that last rinse, the water looked a little bit white. The machine is spinning at a speed, and sometimes the force of the water can make the water look a little choppy. All right, so the rug is about 95% dry. Now that stain is still there. And we're gonna have to work on that now as the rug is drying and then once the rug is fully dry. Now, it's a beautiful sunny day in Farmingdale, New York. So we're gonna take the rug outside, let the UV light and let the sunlight kind of help us dry the rug. And then we're gonna try a few things on that stain outside. When it's all finished, we'll show you the results.